greetings to you in the sovereign and mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Welcome this morning. So good to have you connected with us. We greet you, all the sons and the daughters of the living God throughout the nations, to our fellowship at Christ Kingdom Ministries, to all our beloved of United Christ and the sons of prophets. We welcome you. I thank God that even in the midst of this lockdown, that we can be connected via media. So we give God praise for this media. I trust this morning as you open your hearts to receive the word of the living God, that the son of this house, Pastor Irving Muggan, will be ministering this morning. I'm really excited this day because we are believing God for a miracle. We are believing God for healing. And as a servant of the Lord will minister, I want you to be focused. I want you to stir up your faith. I want you to be encouraged that when the prayers come, the miracle will come into your home this day. We thank you again for connecting with us. Please, beloved, as you connect with us and you receive the word of the Lord, we encourage you to pass the word along to as many as possible so they too can be blessed this day. We're going to call upon the seventh prophet, Clive, that will open in prayer. Let us get ready for prayer. Amen. Let us pray. Father, we come to you today in the powerful, the never failing, the name above every other name. We come to you in the name of Jesus Christ. We declare today, Father, even as we get into worship, even as we get into the word, that the sound of your name will resonate in our areas, in our offices, in our cars, wherever we may stand, that your name will be lifted up, Father, higher than any other name, that every situation that confronts us will be brought to nothing as we raise the name of Jesus, the one they call the Christ, that lived, that died and reigned forevermore. We declare that this is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice in the situation. We will rejoice in this invitation. We will rejoice. No weapon formed against us will prosper. That your name will stand against any weapon. That our financial situation is changing. Yes, that there's healing coming our way.
Yes,
we declare that even the atmosphere over Africa, the atmosphere of the world is changing at the sound of the name of the Lord. For your words that every knee will bow.
Yes.
Every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. And today, as we gather together throughout this nation, throughout this land, listening to this word, we declare that the word will shift our situation. It will turn things around.
Yes.
It will cause an uplifting in our spirit.
In
and
Jesus.
It is done. It is finished. In the name of Jesus Christ, by his blood, we declare this day. Amen. Amen. Even as we get ready to celebrate in worship, let us lift up our voices and sing together with the team as we worship this King of Kings and Lord of Lords.
You've done for me.
Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave.
Family and friends, and we're so blessed that you could connect with us online at Christ Kingdom Ministries. And once again, we just want to welcome our family and friends in United in Christ, SOTP, and family and friends across the globe. Thank you for joining us. And we believe that you are going to be blessed, and we believe that God has a miracle in store for you. Amen. And this morning, even as I share, as we look around and see that as a nation, as a people globally, we are faced with the increase in the number of infections of this coronavirus. And I really got stirred up in my heart to encourage you this morning that even though there might be an increase in the infections, but we need to ramp up in our faith. Amen. In our faith for healing. Amen. In our faith for miracles. Amen. In our faith for signs and wonders.
That's right.
Because He is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we ask or think or imagine.
Amen.
Nothing is impossible with Him. The power that raised Jesus from the dead abides and arises within us. And we need to be stirred up to rise up in faith for healing this morning. When we look at the word in Hebrews chapter 12, verse 2, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. That word looking talks about undivided attention. Looking away from every distraction, every disturbance, every report that is contrary to the Word of God. Having your heart and your faith fixed upon the Lord Jesus Christ. So looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before Him endured the cross for you and I, despising the shame, and has sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. Jesus is the perfect will of God. John 6:38. Jesus is saying, for I have come down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of Him who sent me. What did God the Father send Jesus to do? Luke chapter 4, verse 18, a familiar scripture. And Jesus is saying, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because He has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal
the brokenhearted. To heal the brokenhearted. To proclaim liberty to the captives. And recovery of sight to the blind. To set at liberty those who are oppressed. You might be oppressed or depressed because of some sickness or some illness or some infection that might have come upon you, some virus. But he promises to set at liberty those who are oppressed. And in verse 19, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord. This is a year of jubilee. And in the year of jubilee is a year of supernatural debt cancellation. It's interesting that the word in Luke 4:18 is the same word that Isaiah prophesied in Isaiah 61 verses 1 to 2. That is the mandate that has been given to the senior pastor of this church at Christ Kingdom Ministries, Pastor Anil. The Lord gave him a word in Isaiah 61, which is the same word in Luke 4:18. Wow, that's amazing. But this is exactly what Jesus came to do. He was sent for a specific purpose, for a specific mandate. To fulfill what the Father had sent him to do. In Acts chapter 10, verse 38, it says how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, who went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed. He went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed. That word, you might say, was for that time, but no, it is for today. This is a now word, because faith is now. This word is for you and I, for now, that he has come to do good and healing all who are oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. And we know that God is with us. Jesus is with us this day. Friends and family, I want to give you an assurance that it is God's will to heal you. Look at the word in Luke chapter 13. Picking up from verse 11. And behold, there was a woman who had a spirit of infirmity 18 years. And was bent over and could no way raise herself up. But when Jesus saw her, he called her to him and said to her, woman, you are loosed from your infirmity. And he laid his hands on her, and immediately she was made straight and glorified God. When I look at the scripture, a woman who had an infirmity for 18 years, that she couldn't raise herself up. But Jesus called her. But it's interesting to see the order. The order in verse 12 says, when Jesus saw, he called her to him and said to her, woman, you are loosed from your infirmity. He first said the word. He spoke the word. He sent forth the word of healing. He spoke the word of healing to her, that you are loose from your infirmity. Thereafter, he laid hands on her, and immediately she was made straight. So I want to encourage you this morning, that even as I share this word, you need to speak forth. You need to declare, you need to decree, you need to prophesy, speak the word of God like Jesus said to this woman. be thou loose. He said it first, and then he laid hands upon her. One of my favorite scriptures, as you know, is in Mark 11, 23-24. In verse 22, it says, have faith in God. For shortly I say to you, whoever says to this mountain, you need to say and speak like Jesus speaks, be removed and be cast into the sea, and does not doubt in his heart, but believes that those things he says will be done, he will have whatever he says. You and I are prophets of our own life. Like Jesus spoke to that woman. He declared it. He decreed it. And she was loosed and healed. And then laid hands on her. You know, in this time, it's regulated that we put on our masks. But it's also time that when in your home and in your closet, in the time that you spend with the Lord, is to remove that mask and speak forth the word. Speak forth his promises. Declare and decree those things that be not as though they are. Declare your healing. See, faith begins where the will of God is known. Faith begins where the will of God is known. His will for you and I is his word, the word of God. His will for you and I is the word of God. And so, and I want to declare 101 things that God said about his will to heal. 101 things that God has said about his will to heal. And at this point, I want to acknowledge that the 101 things were extracted from Pastor Keith Moore's book. And so I want to bring that acknowledgement firstly, because I got a hold of this a couple of weeks ago as I was just seeking the Lord. And I got to these 101 declarations of what God had said. And I speak this over my life, over my family's life, over friends that are not well, at least once or twice a day. Because it's medicine to my body. It's medicine to my body. And so, we're going to upload this on all the media, on the website, on the Facebook, and have access to it, even at the church office, of the declarations that I'm going to make. And I encourage you to get a hold of this and speak it over your lives, over your family, over your friends, of what God's will is to heal you. Hallelujah. Amen. So let's go into the 101 things God has said about his will to heal. How do we know whether it is God's will to heal us or not? It makes little difference what others say about it. What did God say about it? Remember that God is no respecter of persons. Acts chapter 10 verse 34. And he never changes. Malachi 3:6. So what he has said to them yesterday is saying to you today. God's word is God speaking to me. God's word is God speaking to me. And these statements are taken directly from the Bible with little or no variation. The verbs and construction have been changed to apply to you personally and to sum up the thoughts in some instances. Also, many of these statements are prefaced by phrases like, if you walk in my commandments, if you believe, obey, etc. What did God say? God said the following. I am the Lord that healeth thee. Exodus 15:26. Your days shall be 120 years. Genesis 6:3. You shall be buried in a good old age. Genesis 15:15. You shall come to your grave in a full age, like as a shock of corn cometh in his season. Job 5:26. When I see the blood, I will pass over you, and the plague shall not be upon you to destroy you. Exodus 12:13. I will take sickness away from the midst of you, and the number of days I will fulfill. Exodus 23, verses 25 and 26. I will put none of the diseases you are afraid of. Are you afraid of the coronavirus? He promises, I will put none of the diseases that you're afraid of, but I will take all sickness away from you. Deuteronomy 7:15. It will be well with you, and your days shall be multiplied and prolonged as the days of heaven upon the earth. Deuteronomy chapter 11, verses 9 and 21. I turn the curse into a blessing unto you, because I loved you, and he still loves you. Deuteronomy 23, verse 5, and Nehemiah 13, 2. I have redeemed you from every sickness and every plague. Deuteronomy 28, verse 61, and Galatians 3, 13. As your days, so shall your strength be. Deuteronomy 33, 25. I have found a ransom for you. Your flesh shall be fresher than a child's, and you shall return to the days of your youth. Job 33, verse 24 and 25. God has said, I have found a ransom for you. Family and friends, that ransom is Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. I have healed you and brought up your soul from the grave. I have kept you alive from going down into the pit. Psalm 30, verse 1 and 2. I will give you strength and bless you with peace, shalom, nothing missing, nothing broken. Psalm 29, 11. I will preserve you and keep you alive. Psalm 41, 2. I will strengthen you upon the bed of languishing. I will turn all your bed in your sickness. Psalm 41, 3. I am the help of your countenance and your God. Psalm 43, 5. No plague shall come near your dwelling. Psalm 91, 10. I will satisfy you with long life. Psalm 91, 16. I will heal all, not some, all your diseases. Psalm 103, 3. I sent my word and healed you and delivered you from your destructions. Psalm 107, 20. You shall not die, but live and declare my works. Psalm 118, verse 17. I heal your broken heart and bind up your wounds. Psalm 147, 3. Your years of life shall be many. Proverbs 4, 10. Trust in me. Have faith in me. Trust me brings health to your navel and marrow to your bones. Proverbs 3, 8. My words are life to you, Zoe life, and health and medicine to all your flesh. Proverbs 4, 22. My good report makes your bones fat. Proverbs 15, 30. My pleasant words are sweet to your soul and health to your bones. Proverbs 16, 24. My joy is your strength. A merry heart does good like a medicine. Nehemiah 8, verse 10. And Proverbs chapter 17, verse 22. The eyes of the blind shall be opened. The eyes of them that see shall not be dim. Isaiah 32, verse 3. And Isaiah 35, verse 5. The ears of the dead shall be unstopped. The ears of them that hear shall hearken. Isaiah chapter 32, verse 3, and Isaiah 35, verse 5. The tongue of the dumb shall sing. The tongue of stammerers shall be ready to speak plainly. Isaiah 35, verse 6, and Isaiah 32, verse 4. The lame man shall leap as a hart. Isaiah 35, verse 6. I will recover you and make you live. I am ready to save you. Isaiah 38, verses 16 and 20. I give power to the faint. I increase strength to them that have no might. Isaiah 40, verse 29. I will renew your strength. I will strengthen and help you. Isaiah 40, verse 31. And Isaiah 41, verse 10. To your old age and gray hairs, I will carry you and I will deliver you. Isaiah 46, verse 4. I bore your sickness. Isaiah 53, verse 4. I carry your pains. Isaiah 53, verse 4. I was put to sickness for you. Isaiah 53, verse 10. When I look at that scripture, that I was put for sickness for you, there was a divine exchange. He took upon himself every sickness, pain, and disease, and exchanged to us divine health. Hallelujah. With my stripes, you are healed. Isaiah 53, 5. I will heal you. Isaiah 57, verse 19. Your light shall break forth as the morning, and your health shall spring forth speedily. He's going to do a quick work. He's going to do it suddenly. Isaiah 58, verse 8. I will restore health unto you, and I will heal you of your wounds, saith the Lord. Jeremiah 30, verse 17. Behold, I will bring it health and cure. I will cure you. I will reveal unto you the abundance of peace and truth. Jeremiah 33 verse 6. I will bind up that which was broken, and I will strengthen that which was sick. Ezekiel 34 verse 16. Behold, I will cause breath to enter into you, and you shall live. I shall put my spirit in you, and you shall live. Ezekiel 37 verse 5 and 14. And when I looked at the scripture that I will cause breath to enter into you, the Ruach of God, the breath of God that He's breathing into you, and some of the information that has come to us during this coronavirus is that it affects your lungs and your breathing. And people have been put on ventilators. So it affects your lungs and your breathing. But His promise to you and I is that His breath is healing. His ruach over us, over our lungs. As He enters and breathes upon us, we shall live. Hallelujah. Whatsoever the river shall come shall live. They shall be healed, and everything shall live where the river comes. Ezekiel 47, 9. Seek me, and you shall live. Amos 5, verses 4 and 6. I have risen with healing in my wings. Malachi chapter 4, verse 2. I will be thou clean. Matthew 8 verse 3. I took your infirmities. Matthew 8 17. I bore your sicknesses. Matthew 8 17. If you are sick, you need a physician. I am the Lord, your physician. I am that I am, the great I am. He is your physician. Matthew chapter 9 verse 12 and Exodus 15 verse 26. I moved with compassion towards the sick, and I healed them. Friends and family, He loves you. His heart is towards you. His compassion is towards you. I moved with compassion towards the sick, and I healed them. Matthew 14, verse 14. I healed all manner of sickness. All manner of sickness. And all manner of disease. Matthew 4, verse 23. According to your faith, be it unto you. According to your faith, be it unto you. Matthew 9, 29. I give you power and authority over all unclean spirits to cast them out and heal all manner of sickness and all manner of disease. Matthew 10 verse 1 and Luke 9 verse 1. I heal them all. Matthew 12 verse 15 and Hebrews 13 verse 8. As many as touch me, like the woman, touch his garment. As many as touch me are made perfectly whole. Perfectly whole. Matthew 14 verse 36. Healing is the children's bread. Matthew 15 26. I do all things well. I make the deaf to hear and the dumb to speak. Mark 7 verse 37. If you can believe, all things are possible to him that believeth. Mark chapter 9 verse 23, Mark chapter 11 verse 23 and 24. When hands are laid on you, you shall recover. Mark 16, verse 18. My anointing, because he's the anointed one. My anointing heals the brokenhearted and delivers the captives, recovers sight to the blind, and set at liberty those who are bruised. Luke chapter 4, verse 18, Isaiah chapter 10, verse 27, and Isaiah chapter 61, verse 1. I heal all those who have need of healing. Luke 9, verse 11. Are you in need of healing? He promises, I heal all those who are in need of healing. I have not come to destroy men's life, but to save them. Luke chapter 9, verse 56. Behold, I will give you authority over all the enemy's power, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. Luke 10, verse 19. Sickness is satanic bondage, and you ought to be loose today. Luke chapter 13, verse 16, and 2 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 2. In me is life. John chapter 1, verse 4. I am the bread of life. I give you life. John chapter 6, verse 33 and 35. The words I speak unto you are spirit and life. John chapter 6, 63. I have come that you might have life and that you might have it more abundantly. John chapter 10, verse 10. I am the resurrection and the life. John chapter 11, verse 25. If you ask anything in my name, I will do it. What a promise. If you ask anything, whatsoever you ask, in my name, in the name that is above every other name, the name of Jesus Christ, I will do it. John 14, 14. Faith in my name makes you strong and gives you perfect soundness. Acts 3, verse 16. I stretch forth my hand to heal. Acts chapter 4, verse 30. I, Jesus Christ, make you whole, make you complete, makes you nothing missing and nothing broken. I do good and heal all that are oppressed of the devil. Acts 10, verse 38. My power causes diseases to depart from you. Acts chapter 19, verse 12. The law of the Spirit of life in me has made you free from the law of sin and death. Romans chapter 8, verse 2. The same Spirit that raised me from the dead now lives in you. And that Spirit will quicken your mortal body. Romans chapter 8, verse 11. Your body is the member of me. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 15. We are the vine and he's the branches. We abide in him and he abides in us. Your body is the temple of my Spirit. And you are to glorify me in your body. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 19 and 20. If you rightly discern my body, which was broken for you, and judge yourself, you will not be judged, and you will not be weak, sickly, or die prematurely. 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 29 to 31. I set gifts of healing in my body. Family and friends, receive his gifts. Receive the gift of healing that has come to you. I have set gifts of healing in my body. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 9. My life may be made manifest in your mortal flesh. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 10 and 11. I have delivered you from death. I do deliver you. And if you trust me, I will yet deliver you. 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 10. I have given you my name and put all things under your feet. You have dominion. You have dominion because he's called you to be the head and not the tail. He's called you to be from above and not below. I have given you my name and I put all things under your feet. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 21 and 22. I want it to be well with you. And I want you to live long on the earth. Ephesians 6, verse 3. I have delivered you from the authority of darkness. Colossians 1, 13. I will deliver you from every evil work. 2 Timothy 4, 18. I chased the death for you. I destroyed the devil who had the power of death. And I delivered you from the fear of death and bondage. What a promise. Hebrews chapter 2 verse 9, verse 14 and 15. I wash your body with pure water. Hebrews chapter 10 verse 22 and Ephesians 5, 26. Lift up the weak hands and the feeble knees. Don't let that which is lame be turned aside, but rather let me heal it. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 12 and 13. Let the elders anoint you and pray for you in my name, and I will raise you up. James chapter 5, verse 14 and 15. Pray for one another, and I will heal you. James 5, 16. By my stripes, you were healed. 1 Peter 2:24. My divine power has given you all things that pertain unto life and godliness through the knowledge of me. 2 Peter 1:3. Whosoever will let him come and take of the water of life freely. Revelation chapter 22, verse 17. Beloved, I wish above all things that you may prosper and be in health. 3 John 2, hallelujah. 101, not only promises, but facts of healing, of the word of God that he's given you and I. Friends and family, I want to encourage you. Get a hold of this, like I did. Get a hold of this. Meditate on it. Declare it. Speak it aloud to your body, to your family, your loved ones, and your friends. Declare it. Speak it out. Because this is the promises. This is the word for you and I. And so, Father God, we thank you this day. We thank you, Father God, that your people are loose from every sickness, pain, and disease. They are loose this day. And we release your word as your word has gone out into the airwaves. Through all the media. We thank you, Father God, for signs, wonders, and miracles as your people receive your word by faith. We know you are the healer because you sent forth your word and the angels have taken forth the word like Jesus sent forth the word and healed him. And this day, your people are healed and set free and we declare liberty, liberty. In the mighty name of Jesus. Friends and family, as we conclude tonight, And as we play this song, meditate on this. It's aligned to the word and the 101 things God has said about your healing. This word is settled in heaven. You and I are appropriating it. It belongs to us. We are His sons and His daughters. He loves us. He loves us. He thought about us above all things. Because He created us before the foundations of the earth. He knew us while we were yet in our mother's womb. And so be blessed. Be healed and be made whole in Jesus' mighty name. God bless you till we connect again. Amen.
Won't let me go. You have spoken.
Beloved, we're going to continue to believe God for your miracle this morning. And I am trusting in the mighty name of Jesus. There is nothing. There is no sickness. There is no calamity. There is nothing that will stand against the power of the holy name of our Messiah, our Savior, our Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. By the authority vested in us through the blood of Jesus, by the word of the living God. Today, my Father, we take authority on this 19th day. We take authority over this COVID-19 in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth to all our beloved that's affected. All the names that were listed by the sons of the prophet, all the names that are listed of the beloved this day, I come against you in the sovereign and the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I rebuke you. I render your work bound now in Jesus' mighty name. This day, I shut down your power. You have no authority over the beloved of God. This day, in the name of Jesus, I render your words bound. I render it bound. I render it bound. I render it bound. I bring it to no effect now. In the name of Jesus, I release healing to the beloved of God. I declare the covenant of God right now. The chastisement of peace was upon him. This day, by the stripes of Jesus, you are healed. Receive it now. Receive healing right now. Receive the power of God to touch you right now. I call upon the glory of the blood upon you right now. I call upon the glory of his word, for his word is health to your flesh. I prophesy into your lungs. I prophesy healing upon every organ. I prophesy healing. I rebuke every other infirmity. Name every name that is named. You will bow. You infirmity of cancer. You infirmity of every organ. This day, every disease of the body. This day, I command you in the name of Jesus. You let go. You let go now. I shut your word now. I bring your word now. I break your power in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I thank you for the anointing. I thank you, the same Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead. The power of the Holy Spirit. Blow right now. Minister right now. Raise them up from their hospital bed. Wherever they are. I speak light. I speak health. I speak light. I speak health. I prophesy. You will not die before your time. Father, you set the time. I prophesy. You beloved, you will arise and fulfill your destiny. You will arise. And you will see the end of your faith in the mighty name of Jesus. You shall live to bring glory to your God. You shall live to bring praise to your God. My Father, protect their faith right now. You spirit that bring in this anxiety and the spirit of suicide and this worry and depression that is coming upon the children of the living God. I rebuke you by his name in the name of Jesus. I drive you out. I bind you stronghold of the mind. I render you once bound in Jesus' name. I release healing of the mind.
Yes.
Right now.
Yes.
For the joy of the Lord is our strength.
Yes.
Our prayer sound mind.
Yes.
We shall not have a spirit of fear.
Yes.
But love, power, and the sound mind.
Yes.
I pray the mind of Christ.
Yes.
I pray the mind of Christ over your conscience, your subconscious. I pray sanctification of the blood of the Lamb. Father, just one touch and the darkness will flee. I pray the anointing down. I pray the presence of God. I pray the presence of God. Where your presence is, there is no room for darkness in the mighty name of Jesus. And I say thank you.
Thank you.
I declare your recovery right now.
Yes.
By faith.
Yes.
As I stand with the servant of God as he ministered.
Thank you.
I stand with him by his word. I believe the word of God this morning. I believe what has been spoken.
Yes.
I believe the scriptures are true.
Yes.
And we receive it by faith.
Yes.
We receive it by faith.
Yes.
We receive it by faith.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus, rise up and walk.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus, rise up and be strong.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus, rise up and be made whole.
Yes.
In Jesus' name, I release the blessing of God to your life. I release the glory and this power of God through His word over your bodies right now. In the name of Jesus, I prophesy no evil shall befall you.
Yes.
Neither shall any plague come nigh unto you.
Yes.
I declare and decree, under His wings you shall take refuge.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
I declare, Lord, you are the shield about us.
Yes, you are, Lord.
And the glory amongst
us, praise you, Father.
Over us. I thank you for the wall of fire around us. I release the blood to our beloved.
Yes,
to all our families and loved ones,
Lord.
I seal you
with
the blood of the Lamb.
Praise
I declare you shall not be a statistic.
Yes.
I prophesy you shall not be a statistic of this COVID-19.
Amen.
And every other disease in Jesus' mighty name.
Jesus name.
And so it is written, with long life, I will satisfy you.
Yes,
and I will show you my glory.
Yes.
I speak this healing.
Yes.
I speak this healing.
Yes.
I speak this. Come on, beloved. Receive this healing.
Yes.
Receive it. Come on, you're going to fight.
Yes.
You're going to fight. And don't let go. Take this word. You can be healed of your cancer.
Yes.
You can be healed of every infirmity.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, receive it.
Yes.
Receive it. I release this power right now in the name of Jesus. So, my Father, I say thank you for hearing
us. Thank you, Lord.
So, my Jesus, I say thank you for hearing us.
Thank you.
We will testify of your goodness and grace and mercy. We will testify of the mighty acts of our God.
Yes.
I give you praise. I give you glory, and I give you honor. Hallelujah.
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 Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Beloved of God, be blessed. The hand of God is upon you.
Yes.
You are not born to be a quitter, to give up.
Yes.
But you will stand. For the power of God is working upon you now.
Mm.
I say stand. Speak faith. Speak life. Speak it now. Over yourself. Believe, 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 and it shall be done in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We love you. We appreciate you. We're looking forward to hear your good report. We're looking forward to hear what God has done into your life.
Amen.
And so we bless you wherever you are, which to the nations of the world. Thank you again for connecting with us. Advance, send this message to all your friends and loved ones this day. And we look forward to connect with you on Tuesday night at 7 p.m. We love you. Again, I'd like to say to you, in the midst of this time of this COVID-19, give the enemy no room. I ask you to protect yourself when you're going out there and shopping and wherever you're going out to your workplaces. I think you need to follow the rules, sanitize, social distancing, and keep your mask on. And I say to you this day, when you come home, you follow the rules, you sanitize, you cleanse yourself. And I tell you what, oh, beyond that, we have the blood.
Hallelujah.
Beyond that, we have our God.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a time to fear, but it is also a time to keep safe.
Amen.
We love you. God bless you. In Jesus' name.
This day in history, death is beaten, you have rescued me. Sing it out, Jesus is alive. Empty cross and empty grave, life eternal.